I am Katha Vachika and welcome to the realm of Katha. Till date, we have presented in front of you several stories from Betal Pachisi. Continuing with the same series, we bring you some more. So, here we go. Heaving Betal on his shoulder, Raja Vikram started his journey again. And so does the Katha. So first story is about a king and his three wives. All the queens were very beautiful, but they were very sensitive. One day, the king was talking to his first wife when a flower from her hair fell and landed on her feet. She shouted in pain. King was amazed to see that the flower has left a wound on her feet. He immediately called doctor and asked them to attend to her. One day, the king was talking to his second wife on the rooftop. He was amazed to see that the second wife's skin started burning with the moonlight. Again, he had to call the doctors. Few days later, the third wife was sitting in her room. Suddenly, she heard a loud cry from the next room. Hearing the cry, she felt very anxious and fainted. Immediately, doctors were called. At this point, Betal stopped his story and asked King Vikram, "So, dear King Vikram, who do you think is the most sensitive out of the three queens?" King Vikram thought for a while and then replied, "Betal, the person who is sensitive to the pain of others is the most sensitive person in this world. So, according to me, third queen is the most sensitive out of all the three queens." Hearing the reply, Betal smiled and said, "You are right, King Vikram, but I have to go." And he flew away. So, the journey started again, and so did the story. So, this story is about Mother Bhagwati and her daughter Dhanvati. One day, Bhagwati and Dhanvati were walking down the street when they saw a man who was tied up. Dhanvati was feeling very thirsty. She asked the man about water and he told her that there is a pot of water in the next lane. The man requested Dhanvati to bring some water for him too. There was a soldier sitting next to the man. When Bhagwati inquired about this man with the soldier, he told her that he is a thief and he will be hanged tomorrow. The thief then asked Bhagwati whether her daughter is married or not. When Bhagwati said that Dhanvati is unmarried, the thief proposed his marriage to Dhanvati. Bhagwati was taken aback, but then the thief explained to her, "Throughout my life, I have collected a lot of jewels and I have hidden them in a very secret place. If you agree to marry me and Dhanvati, I will disclose the location of that place to you. In return, all I want her son to do my pintan, an Indian ceremony for the deceased." Hearing this, Bhagwati agreed and Dhanvati and the thief got married. After marriage, the thief disclosed the location to them and the very next day he was hung. Bhagwati and Dhanvati went to that place, dug it up and brought the jewels with them to their home and started living a very lavish lifestyle. Few days later, a sage visited them. After a few more days, he proposed marriage to Dhanvati. Bhagwati thought it is good that he would stay with us, so she agreed and she married off Dhanvati and the sage. But he was no sage, he was a thief in disguise. The very next day after marriage, the thief took off with all the jewels and left them high and dry. Bhagwati was not able to take this shock and she died. Few months later, Dhanvati gave birth to a son, but she had no money. Every day, she and her son would walk around the streets and would beg for money and food. One day, when they were continuing with their daily routine, they saw a huge python who was trying to strangulate a king. Dhanvati's son quickly rushed to save the prince. He was able to untangle the snake from the prince's neck, but he wasn't able to save him. At the same moment, the king arrived and he saw how Bhagwati's son was helping the prince. Though he was sad, he asked Dhanvati and her son to accompany him to the palace. There, he asked Dhanvati if he could adopt her son, to which Dhanvati agreed. And they started living in the palace. Her son learned all the arts of wisdom. One day the king felt very, very ill and he asked for the new prince. His dying wish was to make him the new king. After the king died, Dhanvati and his son went to the riverside to do the pindan. As they were near the river, three hands came up. At this point, Betal stopped and asked King Vikram, "King Vikram, out of the three hands, one hand was of the thief, second hand was of the thief disguised as sage, and the third hand was of the king. Whom do you think the son should give pindan to and consider his real father?" King Vikram thought for a while and then he said, "Betal, in my opinion, thief was his real father. The thief disguised as sage married Dhanvati because he wanted to run away with her jewelry. The king married Dhanvati because he wanted someone who can take care of his kingdom. The thief was the only one who married Dhanvati without any ulterior motive. Instead, he gave away all his wealth. So, thief was the right choice." Hearing this, Betal smiled and said, "You are right, King Vikram. But you opened your mouth, so I have to go." And he flew away. And so it all started again. Betal started his new katha. So this katha is about a princess of a very big kingdom. She was very beautiful. One day, she decided to go and visit the bazaar of the kingdom. While walking through the bazaar, she saw a bird whisperer. And she was amazed by his skills. She wished she knew the skill. After walking for a few more miles, she came across a weaver. He was knitting a very beautiful loom. She was really impressed by his skills and invited him to the palace. Few miles ahead, she saw a doctor. He was treating the ill and healing them nicely. She was really moved by his compassion and invited him to the palace too. Only a few steps ahead, she was attacked by dacoits. A very smart and handsome soldier came around and he saved the princess and took her safely to the palace. At this point, Betal stopped and asked King Vikram, "So King Vikram, whom should the princess marry?" To which King Vikram replied, "Betal, the queen was only attracted to the skills of the bird whisperer, the weaver and the doctor. But it was the soldier who protected her. A husband should be able to keep his wife safe. Since the soldier was able to protect her, I think she should marry the soldier." Listening to this, Betal smiled. But he said, "Now it's time for me to go." And he flew away. So these were today's katha. Until next time, namaste.